If you don't mind, I will go down to the village to fetch a bucket of water for Grandmama. That is to say, Peter forgot to do it this morning.
If you're already down there, stop by the station. A package has arrived for you.
A package? For me? Oh, how exciting! Wouldn't you like to accompany me and see what's in it?
No, Heidi. I have no time for those things. I must go up into the mountains and repair the damage caused by the storm last night.
Many thanks, little one.
Oh no, I'm too late. The gate is closed. Is there no other way for me to get the package? I see. It's not for me, it's for salesman friends. Perhaps he got the packages mixed up and has taken mine along.
The Wolf and the Seven Little Goats. Once upon a time, there were seven little goats alone at home. Suddenly, someone knocked at the door. A deep, rough voice spoke.
Open the door. It's me, your mother.
The little goats did not fall for the tricks of the bad wolf. Even after he softened his voice with chalk, the little goats recognized him by his black paw. It wasn't until after he dipped his paw in white dough, making it as white as the paws of their mother, that he was able to fool the little goats, upon which they opened the door. The little goats hid throughout the whole house, but the wolf found them all and ate them. Only the smallest, which was hiding in the clock case, he was not able to find. Shortly after, the mother goat returned to find an empty house. With help from the seventh little goat, she cut the sleeping wolf's belly open. The other children were well, as the wolf had swallowed them whole in his greed. They filled his belly with rocks. When the bad wolf woke up, he was terribly thirsty. He went to the well, where the heavy stones pulled him down into the depths. The little goat shouted, "The wolf is dead! The wolf is dead!" since they no longer needed to fear that villain.
I have a package here for you, sir. Unfortunately, I already ripped it open because I thought it was mine. I'm sorry.
Oh, I was in such a hurry. I must have taken the wrong package. I was so confused this morning. A gentleman was hiking yesterday and was surprised by a storm. He fell and lost all his belongings, and now he insists I immediately telegraph someone to bring him a new pair of whatever he needs. But I cannot just close my shop during the middle of the day.
Perhaps I can help you.
That would be very kind, young lady. Bring this note to the telegraph office.
My pleasure, but first I will bring the package to Grandmama. The postman lost a letter from Mr. Gouchy.
That is absolutely delightful, little one. Who is the package from?
I'm not sure. One moment. Oh my, there's a little dog inside.
Oh, how sweet. I'm sure there is also a letter. Don't you want to read it?
It says, "Dearest Heidi, I found this little mischief and fed him up. He reacts when you whistle for him, and sometimes he digs up things. Unfortunately, I may not keep this adorable creature here in the boarding school. Therefore, I would like you to have him. With very best regards and love from your friend Clara."
That's a good boy. Try and see if he listens to you.
I can't.
Oh, that's not a problem, little one. It's very easy to practice and learn.
Turn to face the dog and press the X key. The longer you hold it, the deeper the breath Heidi will take. As soon as you let go, she will whistle after the dog, who will then follow her for a certain amount of time.
Do you think he really can dig things up out of the ground?
You may try it with the carrots behind the house.
The dog can dig things out when Heidi is standing near a respective symbol. Make sure the dog is following her. Then press the return key to start searching.
Many thanks, little one.
Oh, goodness! I almost forgot about the mail order at the telegraph office. Lunch break. Closed. Oh, Then I will have to come back later, and I can show the little Dr. Peter now. Jacks. Jacks.
Good to see you, Heidi. That was a terrible storm last night. Would you help me repair the bridge so I can return the goats to the upper pasture?
I've already heard about it from the salesman. He told me about a wealthy gentleman who was hiking and lost all of his belongings in the canyon.
Let us search for his belongings when we have repaired the bridge, Heidi.
Oh yeah, and I already know who will be able to find the missing planks from the bridge. This little four-legged creature here. That is to say, he belongs to the family from now on.
A little dog. I can't believe it. Very well. Then you look for the missing planks, and I will bring the goats to a pasture where they will have no chance to run away. So long.
Jacks.
All right.
Good job, Heidi. Now we can start off. What are we looking for anyway?
The following items are on the order list. A bag for provisions, a purse, a pocket knife, and a wandering hat.
A hat? Heidi, I remember seeing a hat in the forest this morning. I'll run off and fetch it.
In the meanwhile, then, I will search for the other things.
Thank you.
What in the world is taking Peter so long?
Imagine this. A cheeky little squirrel stole the hat from right in front of my nose. If you agree, I will take along these things and bring them to the salesman in the village.
Good. And I will go to Grandfather and introduce him to our new family member. Clara has sent me a little dog. I may keep him, right?
I don't mind, Heidi. What shall that Rugrat's name be?
Your name shall be Alfie.
Heidi was extremely happy when she fell asleep on this evening. The little dog would have a wonderful life with her, and he would surely be a loyal friend, even if he slept all the time, Heidi thought to herself. That, however, is a story which we would like to tell another time.